Hi, I'm Brittany with the Tennis Warehouse Racquet Review. This is the Mantis 300. As part of the new racquet lineup for the Mantis brand, the Mantis 300 offers a combination of control, maneuverability, and feel. It features a 100 square inch head size, a swing weight of 313, weighs in at 11 ounces strong, and has a stiffness rating of 67. First up, we have Jason. Jason, you like to hit heavier, more spin-oriented shots, especially on the forehand side. How did this Mantis 300 work out for you?
I had mixed emotions about this play test. On one hand, on the positive side, it was very maneuverable. I thought it was really easy to swing, which helped me be consistent on my serve, great up at net. And like you said, I thought it was really easy on the spin. Great access to spin from all areas of the court. Really on my serve, it helped a lot too. But on the other hand, the negatives were that I was able to get so much spin because I was able to take big cuts at the ball because it was underpowered. I thought this racket either needed to be heavier overall in weight or needed to be a bit more head heavy. And also, my other gripe was just the stiffness. Even though I enjoyed the feel, it didn't feel that great on my arm after a hit. I just could feel it because of my arm issues. But yeah, it was just a little too underpowered and too firm for my taste.
Next up, we have Carly. Carly, it's her birthday today. Happy birthday.
Thank you.
Now, you have a very aggressive style game, like to put the ball away. How did you like the Mantis 300?
The thing that stood out the most to me of the Mantis was the maneuverability and the control. I thought it was easy to swing, easy to direct the ball where I wanted it to go. That made me comfortable to come up to net with this racket. Especially against hitting hard hitters, I felt I could get the racket on the ball, even if it was hit hard at me. And then with that control, if it was hit hard, I could still keep it in the court without it soaring out. The one downside, though, for me was the stiffness. And it wasn't that I really felt that during play, because I like a stiffer racket just because of the stability. But afterwards, my wrist, it was very sore after playing, and I don't know if that's because of a wrist injury that I had last year, but it was a little bit on the stiffer side for me. But overall, the maneuverability and the control, I thought, made it a good racket to play with.
Next up, we have Tiffany. Tiffany, you've play-tested a lot of rackets with a similar spec. How did you like the Mantis 300?
I think this fit right in there with the competition, and it also fit my game pretty well. It really swings really quickly, and so I felt like I could take the ball really early. Jay had said that it felt a little underpowered to him, but I think that might be because he likes to generate his own power, whereas I like to step in and, when I can do it, take the ball early and use my opponent's power to fire it right back at them, and I think this did it really well. I think the stiffness helped out there. The other two had mentioned that they had some wrist issues and arm issues after playing with this racket, and I didn't notice the stiffness so much with any arm issues or wrist issues unless I mishit the ball. If I shanked it, then I really could feel it. So I think maybe the full bed of poly that I was using while testing the racket might have contributed to that stiff feel. But overall, I really liked it because I could step in really early, take that ball, and have really good control. So it helped me become a little bit more aggressive. So overall, good fit for my game.
I also play tested the Mantis 300, and the specs are exactly what I look for. Like the other play testers, I found this racket to be very maneuverable, very easy to swing. I had my best results when I took relaxed, looser swings, and I really enjoyed hitting volleys and slice with this racket. I felt I was able to keep my slice low and my volleys had great touch and feel. One thing that I didn't like Jason mentioned, was I felt it was a little bit underpowered. When I was hitting against players that hit heavier and harder balls, I was able to use their pace to create the depth that I wanted. However, when I had to create my own pace, I struggled to hit with power and with depth. Overall, I loved the maneuverability and the feel of this racket. As you heard, our playtesters enjoyed the maneuverability and the control of the Mantis 300. If you're interested in this racket, please visit tenniswarehouse.com. Thanks for watching.